This is a demonstration of how to use the Rapid Response COVID-19 Antigen Rapid Test Device. This video will explain the following. The materials you will need to conduct the test. Setting up your workspace. The steps to collect a nasal specimen using a nasal swab. The steps to process the sample and run the test. And how to interpret the results of the test. Please note that this video is for demonstrative purposes only and is not intended to replace the instructions supplied in your kit box. Please read the product insert before conducting the test. Materials. To conduct the test, you will need the following materials. A test device. A sterile swab. A tube stand. An extraction tube. And a nozzle with a filter. You will also need the extraction buffer. If you are using the 5-pack version, your kit will come with 5 single-use extraction buffer vials. If you are using the 25-pack version, it will come with 25 single-use extraction buffer vials or 2 extraction buffer bottles, or both. The 5-pack has perforated holes in the top right corner of the kit box that can be used instead of the tube stand. A clock, timer, or stopwatch is also required for the test but is not provided in the kit. Setting up your workspace. Bring all the test materials to room temperature and wash or sanitize your hands before beginning the test. Begin by opening the pouch and removing the test device. Place the device on a clean, level surface. Use a permanent marker to label it with your initials or the initials of the person who is being tested. Label one extraction tube in the same way and place it upright in the tube stand. Or, if you are using the 5-pack box as a tube stand, empty the box completely, then use a pen to puncture one of the perforated holes on the front. Once the perforated hole is large enough, insert the extraction tube. The test procedure shown in the rest of the video is the same for those using the tube stand and those using the kit box. Depending on the type of kit you have received, you will be using either an extraction buffer bottle or an extraction buffer vial. This video will provide instructions for both. To use the single-use extraction buffer vial, twist open the tag of the vial. Then empty the entire contents of the vial into the extraction tube. To use the extraction buffer bottle, gently mix the bottle, then open the cap, and add 10 drops of the buffer to the extraction tube in your tube stand. The test procedure shown in the rest of the video is the same for those who have used the extraction buffer bottle and the extraction buffer vial. Collecting the anterior nasal swab specimen. Blow your nose with a tissue before you collect the sample. Open the swab by peeling back the packaging. The swab will open from the stick end. Remove the swab from the packaging. Be careful not to touch the absorbent tip of the swab to any surfaces, including your hands. Tilt your head back 70 degrees. Insert the swab at least 1/2 inch inside the nostril through the anterior nares until you encounter mild resistance. Using a circular motion, rotate the swab inside the nostril for 5 seconds. Press your nostril with your fingers to trap the swab tip and rotate the swab for 5 more seconds. Remove the swab from the nostril and insert it into the other nostril. Repeat the same steps on the other side using the same swab. Processing the sample to run the test. Now you are ready to process the sample. Begin by inserting the swab with the collected specimen into the extraction tube with the extraction buffer solution. Then pick up the tube with the swab in it. Swirl the swab, mixing it well. Squeeze the swab 10 to 15 times by compressing the walls of the tube against the swab. Place the swab and test tube back into the tube stand. Set a timer and wait 2 minutes before continuing. After the 2 minutes are up, pick up the extraction tube and remove the swab from the tube while squeezing and pressing the swab head firmly against the inner wall of the tube to release as much liquid as possible from the swab. Remove the swab and throw it in the garbage. Then, attach the nozzle to the extraction tube. Invert the tube and add 3 drops of the sample to the sample well at the bottom of the test device by gently squeezing the tube. Do not add the sample to the results window, which is the longer window above the sample well. Set a timer and wait 15 minutes before reading the results. While you wait for your results, wash your hands thoroughly or use hand sanitizer. Results interpretation. Read the results 15 minutes after you added the sample to the sample well. Results interpretation is easy. The test result is positive if there are 2 colored lines, just like a pregnancy test. One line will appear in the control region, C, and another line will appear in the test region, T. It is important to note that the color intensity in the test region may vary depending on the concentration of viral particles present in the sample. Therefore, any line in the test region, no matter how faint, should be considered a positive result. The test result is negative if only one colored line appears in the control region, C, and there is no apparent colored line in the test region, T. The test result is invalid if the control line fails to appear. Results from any test which has not produced a control line at the specified read time must be discarded. Please review the procedure and repeat it with a new test. If the problem persists, discontinue using the kit immediately and contact your local distributor. This is a qualitative test only, and the intensity of the test line cannot determine the viral load of your nasal sample. Once you have read your results, dispose of the swab, test device, extraction tube, and nozzle, and the single-use buffer vial. If you are using the bottle buffer, do not dispose of it until you have completed all the tests in your kit box. Do not dispose of the tube stand either, as both items can be reused for future tests. Choose rapid response. It's simple.